Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. I am Lidya Kimeu from SOS Technical Training Institute in Buruburu, Phase 2. We have been making a shot. This far, we have made the hip pocket, we have made the bound pocket, we have made the fly front opening, and we have also hemmed our shot. We are now going to attach the waistband in this lesson, and we already have our waistband pieces, and we have our belting, and also our belt carrier pieces. We'll start by making the belt carrier pieces. Take your belt carrier piece, fold the edges to the center on both ends, then fold in half. Yeah? So once again, as I repeat, fold the edges of the belt carrier piece to the center and then fold halfway so that the edges, the two turned in edges, meet, and then stitch that end fast. Ensure that your stitching line is right at the edge and keep a consistent width or size of the belt carrier loop. Go folding as you work. If you're not able to do so, tuck, then attach, then work on the machine. Ensure that your stitching line is right at the edge of the fold lines, keeping a consistent width or size of your belt carrier. This one will be 3/8 of an inch. Once you have worked on that side, turn and now stitch the folded end. Ensure that also this stitching line is right at the edge. Cut off your thread. And even at the other end. And now cut your belt carriers. They should be 2 inches because our belt, 2¼ inches because our waistband is 1¼ inches. So 2¼ inches, measure out and cut. We will require 6 to 8 belt carrier pieces. I will be using 6 belt carriers. Once you have cut your belt carrier pieces, this is the way they look. And that's what we shall now attach to our shot. We will start by attaching the belt carrier pieces to the shot at the front in the center between the zip opening and the pocket. You can just mark quickly and place it at the center. Attach. Attach another at the side seam, because when somebody sits down, they will have their trouser or their short go down at the side seam. So ensure you have one at the side seam. Attach another at the dart at the back, or slightly like 1 inch away from the dart, so that we will not need to attach another at the back crutch line. Ensure the ones near the back crutch line are closer together. And as you attach, match the positions on the other side. Keep trimming your thread, it works better. And the front one, which is the last one, at the center, between the center front opening and the pocket. We have now attached all our belt carriers. There are 6 of them. We shall now attach our waistband pieces to the waist. We shall now attach our belt pieces. On the left-hand side, leave an extension of about 2 inches and attach your waistband to the short. Be careful not to hit the stop tab of the zip with your needle. And cut. This is the stop tab. It's the one that stops the zip from running through, and it should always be slightly below your zip seam, your waistline seam. And that's the one I'm saying you should avoid or be careful with, because it will break your needle. Now attach the other waistband. Ensure that you take the same seam allowance so that at the end of the day, one side is not longer than the other. Yes, just to be sure, you can close your zip to see that your waistbands meet and one is not higher than the other. Now, on the left hand side, fold your center front opening the way I have. The main aim is to fold your waistband over and stitch it down up to half an inch. Don't stitch the whole of it, leave half an inch. So fold it right at the edge and stitch it down using the same seam allowance or seam line used earlier. Remember to leave your half inch unstitched. Yeah. When you turn your waistband, that's the way it should look. We will then, and then on the right hand side, just cut off the excess and leave half an inch also as your seam allowance. You realize at the center back we did not leave any as seam allowance because there is already seam allowance in this area. So if there's any hanging like this one, cut it out. Usually we cut the waistband slightly longer. Yeah. Now we shall attach. Having attached our waistband, we shall now stitch down the belt carrier loops, and you ensure that they are equal to the waistband piece. So hold them down. They should not slant, but lie flat. Don't need to cut off the thread, just continue stitching. And also for the other end. Cut off all the threads now. That's the way it should be when stitched down. That needs to be redone. Rethread your machine and just work on it. The reason we are holding it down is as we apply the belting, then we'll only be working on the belting and not the loops and the belting.
And touch the loops for the other side.
Cut off all the threads. And now we shall attach the belting. Once you have attached the loops, that's the way they should look. We shall now attach our belting. We start off with the left hand side. The seam allowance that we left is what we shall use to attach our belting. Now, as we attach our belting, there should be the top seam allowance left. And the belting usually is wider than the waistband. So attach it together in the seam allowance that you left. Which was 1/2 inch. And this is at the center front edge. It's not exactly on center front, but it is the center front edge. Ensure there are no pieces underneath. And stitch. Once you have attached it at that point, that's the way it should look. Then we shall make the seam up here. We shall make the seam up there, up to that point, and then use the overlaid seam to attach the belting to the waistband. Turn it completely. Be careful to retain a straight edge. This edge should be straight. This edge here should be straight. And stitch. Mm-hmm. then turn it back. And now, using the overlaid seam, open up your seam to lie on top of the waistband like that, and we hold down the belt. Using the overlaid seam, place your belting over the waistband, carefully over the waistband, ensuring that your seam allowance is kept constant, meaning your waistband size will be constant, or waistband width. Hold your loop down and stitch. Keep your seam allowances even. And cut off the extra because we are using it on the other side. That is the way the belting should look after it has been attached. Finish off the ends that we undid. Now we will attach on the other side. We will start off by attaching the belting to the waistband using the overlaid seam. Ensure that you keep to your seam line. Hold your loops down. Straight, not slanted. Yeah, and then now make the front edge seam. Fold the belting over and attach the belting to the waistband on the center front edge. Up to the waistline seam only, not the seam allowances. Cut off your threads. And turn your piece. Push out that corner. If it is too bulky, you can always trim it. That's the way it should look once it is done. Now we shall join the crotch line the back crotch line to make it easy for you to join. You can insert one leg into the other. And then now lay the back crotch line seam. You shall realize that we had greater seam allowance on the back side. This is basically for adjustment purposes. Our seam allowance was that of 1.25 inches. So I shall stitch that 1.25 inches, but also at the back, ensure that your intersecting seams actually intersect or match. None should be higher than the other. They should all be at the same level. If one is higher than the other, it means you took in more seam allowance at one point or less seam allowance than the other. So please balance that out before you put the seams together. Stitch. Still checking that your seams balance. And ensure that your waistline seam allowances face up. Ensure that your waistline seam allowances face up, both under and on top. Still ensuring that your seams intersect correctly. Continue on to make your back crotch seam. And overlap it with the other. We shall then make another continuous one from the top to bottom. Because this is a high strenuous area, that is why we make two seams on this seam. The seam lines should actually lie one on top of the other. And push all the way to the farthest you can go. That's the farthest for me. Reverse stitch and cut. Your seams should intersect. And now we shall hold the seam, the waistband down. To do so, first open your center back seam and fold this end down like that, or trim it off like the other side. Fold it down. Ensure that it lies over the center back seam. And you could catch stitch just to ensure it doesn't move, and we shall undo that seam or that stitch. So you realize that I did not even reverse stitch or reinforce it. It is because we are going to be removing it. Then starting from the left hand side, fold the seam allowance in. And with such threads, just cut them off. Sure, it's a clean job, even if you're going to push all those under. Cut off any excess threads and fold it diagonally at that point. And then working from the right side, we shall sink stitch the waistband in place. How do we work the sink stitching? Pull your waistband seam apart and ensure that your stitching line goes right inside or between your seam at the waistband. Even at the loops, pull them apart, ensuring that the waistband is flat. Check that your loop is not caught by your presser foot. And seam stitch it. Be careful with the loops. Continue working until the end. Be careful with also the pocket opening or pocket mouth. And at this end, also fold the seam allowances and form a diagonal like that, ensuring that all seam allowances are under. That's the way it should look. Be careful with your needle and the stop tab. Don't hit it. Stitch to the end. And the waistband. After you finish your sink stitching, that is the way the waistband will look. On the inside, this is the way it looks. And your belting is held down. You can also choose to use the same color of thread as your belting, but I have used the same color of my shirt. At the center front, your shirt should be equal at the waist. Stay tuned. Today, we have made the short. If you have any questions, you're welcome to visit us at SOS Technical Training Institute. We are located in Buruburu Phase 2. We offer fashion design as a course, and we have it at three levels. At the grade level, which takes 3 years because it goes from grade 3 to 2 and grade 1, we offer NITA exams for that one. And we also offer the craft level, which takes 2 years, module system, where you sit for an exam at the end of each year. That one is examined by NEC, or Kenya National Examination Council. And we also have the diploma level, which takes you 3 years. It is the module system too. And you are examined at the end of every year. And the examining body is Kenya National Examination Council.